The breaking glass on my Range Rover, pay me back or bitch, it's over. All the press. Alright guys, today's the day. I've been promising some people that I'm going to do the 10,000 calorie challenge. So I'm going to do it today. I haven't planned it out, so I don't exactly know what I'm going to be eating, but I have some ideas, like I'm going to throw pizza in there, of course. I mean, how can you not do a 10,000 calorie challenge and not have pizza in there? So I've already weighed myself, so and then at the end I'll weigh myself again and see how much I've put on. So let's get into it. I'm feeling pretty tired and pretty hungry, so hopefully this first meal I can get over 1,000 calories and get started. Alright, so before we start, I've only got two rules. The first one is I can't consume any calories in liquid form. So I can't have milkshakes, I can't have soft drinks. I can, but those calories don't count. So, and the second rule is if I spew, then it's game over, I'm disqualified. So they're the only two rules I have. So let's have a look at my condition first and then we'll get into my first meal. Still have the abs, but probably gonna be gone by the end of today. So this is what I've got for breakfast. I'm starting with 200 grams of bacon. I like to get the bacon without the fat because the fat makes me feel a bit sick. So I like just a shortcut bacon. Eggs, probably gonna try and have 6 eggs maybe. And then a whole can of baked beans in barbecue sauce. So I'm gonna be cooking that, the eggs and bacon in butter. So I got the Western Star butter because I know it's full of calories. It's probably the most calorie dense butter. Just that it's 50 grams here. You can see the 50 gram line. Just that there contains 1,000 calories of 500, I think. So I'm probably just gonna use that slice right there to cook with and put on my crumpets as well. So I got the golden crumpets. The 99% fat-free ones, but I know that crumpets are full of carbs, so, and they're really easy to eat as well, so that's going to help. I'm going to put butter on them and then I'm going to smother them with peanut butter, crunchy peanut butter. So I know that peanut butter is full of fat, so it's going to be higher in calories as well. Now, smother that also in some maple syrup. Alright, so I've just scanned the butter, the Western Star butter on MyFitnessPal app, and I'm just looking now, so we're looking at 50 grams of butter right there, that little block there is 360 calories. So I'm gonna try and use that whole 50 grams for my breakfast. And that's just gonna be 360 calories just for that. Got it. All right guys, so that is my first meal of today. So that there, all up was 1,063 calories. So I wasn't gonna include the spinach because it was only like an extra 10 calories or something. But I was like, you know what? That could be the difference between winning or losing. So I was like, I'll just weigh the spinach anyway. So there's 1,063 calories, and that's not including the extra bit of butter sitting right there, and plus the crumpets and peanut butter I still gotta have yet. Guys, so it's been half an hour, it's now 10 a.m. I'm about to eat two crumpets with butter and peanut butter, and then I'm gonna smash another two of these on the way to the gym. Alright guys, it's only 20 past 10 and I'm about to eat two more crumpets. I got these Ferrero Rochers. Yes! A whole box of 15, so I'm gonna try and eat all these throughout today. So after this, two more crumpets, that'll put me at, what have we got on here? Already 2,197 calories. All right, so I'm on my way to the gym. Going to train legs, so this could work in my favor or it could work against me, because as you know, legs is our biggest muscle group, so I'm gonna burn as much calories as I can. Although, I'm gonna work pretty hard with legs, so I could start feeling pretty sick. That's why I wanna do it now. It's only 10:30 in the morning, so I thought I'd do it now while I don't have too many calories in my stomach, so I don't feel too sick. So I'll get out of the way and then hopefully I can have a big session and then I'll feel hungry even more, so I can go eat some more. I'm just gonna smash a Ferrero Rocher. I have three of these on my way to the gym. I got 15 of these to eat today, so first three down now.
I'm such a fat cunt today. 10,000
calories. A bit of a warm up. I'm just gonna try and stay as active as I can today. I feel like if I stay seated, then I'm just gonna clunk out and just not move. So I'm gonna try and hit this leg session pretty hard. Guys, so I finished my leg sesh. I didn't spew, fortunately, but I didn't go as high as what I'd normally go. But I'm just getting some lunch now. So I've got some sushi. So let's have a look here. Okay, some salmon sushi there, and that's going to put me up to, you can see here. Oh no, it's gone blurry. Fuck.
calories after this meal. Then I'm going to smash a muffin back, which should put me up to about 3.5.
What y'all looking at? It's my muffin. This here muffin has 717 calories. Once I finish this, that's going to put me up to, I'll be on 3,859 calories.
Can you please tell me how many calories this hot dog has in it?
No idea.
No idea? Probably not enough for me. Alright, so about to go get a snack. I really wanted KFC because I prefer KFC, but I've just had a look on MyFitnessPal and Hungry Jack's is more calorie dense than KFC, and also KFC is deep fried, so it's full of oil, so it's probably going to make me feel more sick. So I'm going to go with the Hungry Jack's today, and then we're going to go and get some Krispy Kreme donut.
Look at that.
Hello?
Hi,
I'm just wondering, what is the most calorie dense burger?
Sorry, what was that?
Can I get a fiery Angus burger, please?
Yeah, was that in a meal?
Yeah, with a small chips, please. I'm all about them calories. Alright, I've got my Hungry Jack. Could you believe that? Our small chips is nearly 300 calories. So I got the chips and a fiery Angus burger. This thing has nearly 1,000 calories. So once I finish this, that's gonna put me at around 5,200 calories for the day. I reckon I'm gonna start feeling by the time I finish this. For you guys, my fans.
Oh my God.
Done. Woo! I feel like shit. I am at 5,200 calories so far. So I've just been to Marion and I've got some Krispy Kreme donuts. After I had my burger, I was like, damn, like I feel shit, like I can't eat anymore. And now, like an hour later, not even an hour later, I'm like, boom, I'm ready again. I'm ready to eat and I'm ready to eat donuts. And so I got, yeah, it's just like my metabolism, it's just recovery. I just recovered and I'm ready to go again. What a champ. But anyway, I've got these donuts here. So if you can see here, these delicious donuts. We got a Nutella filled one, okay? So one of these is nearly 300 calories. And then the original glazed ones are nearly 200 calories. So I'm gonna have three of these.
probably gonna have one now and then the rest later. So that'll get me up to about nearly 5,500 calories. And then I'm gonna hit the gym again, just do some light cardio and a bit of arms, I reckon, just to keep active. So if I sit down and if I stay seated, I'm just gonna like probably fall asleep or something. So it's gonna stay active, keep moving, and just try and keep getting those foods in. Go have a couple more Ferrero Rochers, I reckon. If you haven't ever tried one of these, you gotta try a Nutella filled Krispy Kreme donut, because fuck me, they're good. Look at that. 300 calories. Good shit. Oh, that's good. Okay, so next meal, it's 5 o'clock, nearly 5 p.m. This is about meal number 178. Nah, feels like it. But so this meal is 300 grams of mashed potato, 290 grams of Atlantic salmon, and 50 grams of butter. This all up equals 1,176 calories.
Oh shit. I'm on to my last spoon full of a little bit of mashed potato. So if you know me well, you know that I'm a big eater and I eat very, very quickly, but this meal took me a good half an hour to eat. So here goes the last. I'm up to 7,161 calories. About to have dinner. This is what I'm having.
Pizza. How can you do a dirty challenge without pizza? Anyway, barbecue meat lovers, my favourite. I got a bit ahead of myself and I already ate one piece. It was meant to be a 12 inch, but it's only 8 slices, what the hell. Anyways, that pizza is 1,460 calories. So, once I finish this, I should get up to about 8,500, and then I still got my ice cream and rest of my Ferrero Rochers to go. So, hopefully that'll get me over the line.
Our photographer has cracked the shits because I forgot to get garlic bread. So here I am, recording myself eating the pizza. I'm already like nearly halfway through. Smashing it back. It's getting cold though. I'm not liking this. This little piece left. All gone.
Unfortunately, I have to order 6 wicked wings.
Yeah, mate, 6 wings, thank you.
There you go. I'm actually like breathing very heavily. I feel hot, I'm starting to get a headache. I'm starting to feel sick, like this is not easy to do. If you're sitting back and you're thinking, oh yeah, I can eat 10,000 calories. No, you can't. You can't. Maybe you can, but get very close to spewing. Now I'm gonna do it though. All I have to do is eat one more wing And then I got ice cream, 800 calories left, 3 Ferrero Rochers, and then I'm done. Okay, I can do this.
Last meal. This is gonna get me over the line, just. Okay, so that's 265 grams of Connor Sawyer, or however you say it.
Connor
Ice cream, cookies and cream. And then 2 Ferrero Rochers. That's about 800 calories right there. A bit over 800 calories, so smash that. And then that's 10,000 fucking calories down. All right, guys, I'm on the home stretch. Nearly there. Last bit of ice cream. I feel good. I don't feel good. All right, guys, I did it. I ate 10,000 calories today. Got the job done. I didn't spew. I didn't consume anything in liquid form. So, if there's anything I would have done differently, I probably wouldn't have had such a calorie dense, fatty breakfast. I reckon that's what, my breakfast is too big compared to my dinner. I probably would have had a smaller breakfast to start the day and then built up and had a big dinner and finished off with dessert. But other than that, that's probably the only thing I would have done differently. Thanks for watching my 10,000 calorie challenge video today. Hope you liked it. I didn't die, so that was a good thing. You'll see me in the gym tomorrow. I'll be walking around my little belly. And just to finish up, I'll show you how I look right now. You saw how I look. Anyway, this is what I'm like now. As you can see, I'm pretty bloated. And that's a wrap.